Hi everyone, this is Veronica. Today our topic of discussion is about Indian Cobra genome is decoded. So we'll discuss in detail about this. For my video updates and queries, you can connect with me on Instagram and Facebook because I feel together we can make a difference. So now what is the relevance of this topic in your exams? It will be covered in your mains paper 3. And at objective level, you should know about antivenom, and at subjective level about genome sequencing and its applications. So today, in what context we are studying this, because last week an international team of researchers, they have reported that they have sequenced the genome of Indian cobra, in the process identifying the genes that actually defined its venom. So this has provided a blueprint for developing more effective antivenom. So now let me tell you here about the snake bites. India alone accounts for about 50,000 deaths annually, and these are primarily attributed to the big four. So there are big four snakes here which are considered most poisonous snakes in India. One is your Indian cobra, then common crate, Russell's viper and saw-scaled viper. So the challenge here has been producing antivenom for the species which are known here. So in India, common antivenom is marketed for the treatment of bites from these big four snakes, but its effectiveness is very much questionable. While the common antivenom worked as marketed against the saw-scaled viper and the common cobra, it fell short against some neglected species and also against one of the big four, that is your common crate. So accidental contact with snakes, they leads over to 1 lakh deaths across the world every year. So now here we'll discuss about antivenom. See, antivenom is currently produced by a very old process, a century old process. Here what they do, they take a small amount of venom and it is injected into a horse, or sometimes they use a sheep also, then which produces, this animal produces antibodies that are then collected and developed into antivenom. This technique, this process is very expensive, cumbersome, and it comes with complications. So some of the antibodies which are raised from the horse may be completely irrelevant. Now you should understand here that why has production of effective antivenom been challenging, because see, venom is a complex mixture of estimated around 140 odd proteins, or you can say peptides. So only some of these constituents are toxins and they cause the physiological symptoms which are seen after the snake bite. Now, what is the problem here? Antivenom is available today that does not target these toxins specifically. So there are many issues with the present antivenom. The issues being, because the horse has lot of antibodies which are floating in its blood and that have nothing to do with the venom toxins. So one more problem with the horse antibodies are that our immune system, it recognizes it as foreign, and when antivenom, it is given to the human body, to the body, it mounts an antibody response, and this leads to what is known as serum sickness. Okay, so sometimes it becomes severe also, because if also next time if one is unlucky and they have a snake bite incident, even if there it is a different snake and they are given horse derived antivenom, the body is going to have a severe allergic reaction, right? So that is why this genome sequencing would help now, because in the Indian cobra genome, the authors have identified around 19 key toxin genes, the only ones that should matter in snake bite treatment. And they stress the need to leverage this knowledge for creation of antivenom using synthetic human antibodies. So targeting these 19 specific toxins using the synthetic human antibodies should lead to a very safe and effective antivenom for treating Indian cobra bites, right? So that is why the significance, this is where the significance of gene sequence lies, because the genome sequence can provide a blueprint for developing more effective antivenom. So this cobra genome sequence is of really high quality, and sequence information of the genes that code for venom proteins which are toxic is very important for the production of recombinant antivenoms. Let me tell you a little bit about genome sequencing. See, genome is an organism's complete set of DNA that includes all of its genes. So each genome, it contains all the information that is needed to build and maintain that organism. So in humans, a copy of entire genome that contains more than 3 billion DNA base pairs is contained in all the cells that have a nucleus. So genome sequencing is figuring out the order of DNA nucleotides. So here we'll discuss about snakebite and venoming. So what is this? Because WHO has presented a strategy which aimed at cutting snakebite related deaths and disabilities in half by 2030, as snakebite can soon become a major global public health emergency if not dealt properly. So there are many facts that I would give you here, because each year nearly 3 million people are bitten by poisonous snakes, with an estimated around 81,000 to 1,38,000 deaths. So this data is given by WHO. And another, there are 4 lakh survivors who suffer permanent disabilities and other after effects according to WHO figures. So snake venom can cause paralysis that stops breathing, bleeding disorders that can lead to fatal hemorrhage, irreversible kidney failure and tissue damage that can cause permanent disability and limb loss. And from a very long time, snake bite has been neglected and dangerously underestimated, to extend that in 2017, WHO categorized snake bite venoming as neglected tropical disease. So this snake bite and envenoming is a potentially life-threatening disease that typically results from the injection of a mixture of different toxins. This is all that is important for today's lecture. So we discussed that for the Indian cobra, now the genome sequencing for its venom has been done, and it will be very helpful for researchers further to create a specific antivenom for it. So WHO has also made a proper roadmap for snake envenoming, for example, to make antivenoms accessible and affordable. So WHO's plan is to increase the production of the quality antivenoms, and in order to create a sustainable market for antivenoms, there is a need for 25% increase in the number of competent manufacturers by 2030. And WHO planned a pilot project to create a global antivenom stockpile also. So integrating your snake bite treatment and response into national health plans in affected countries, including better training of health and personnel and educating communities, this is going to help fight this snake envenoming, right? So this is all about today's lecture. You can get the PDF of this lecture from my Telegram channel, that is t.me/Veronica_Om. Thank you. So this is a channel, StudyIQ. If you're preparing for UPSC or any government exam, our pen drive and tablet courses are available. If you're preparing for UPSC CSE 2020, our pen drive course is available, where you can find 100% coverage of UPSC VAS syllabus. Daily current affair updates will be available. Self-paced learning process is provided. This course has been prepared by top faculties of StudyIQ, and now you can purchase this course at ₹625 per month only. For additional information, you can visit our site, and there are the phone numbers also given. You can call them and gain the additional information. You can connect with me for my video updates on Instagram and Facebook, because I feel together we can make a huge difference. For queries, you can even email me. Thank you so much.